part in Hyderabad.
I mean, where did you study from and
schooling was done from Kendriya Vidyalaya, followed by engineering and BIT, Vellore, mechanical.
Okay, and you have a work ex or something, like you want to tell anything more about yourself?
No work ex.
Okay, what about you?
So, my name is Siddharth Shetty. I did my mechanical engineering from Father Emil Vashi. I did my schooling in Boisar, Tarapur, until 12th. Then, after graduation, I went on to work in Petrofac Engineering India, Powai, for 25 years.
Okay, what about you?
I'm Sashini. I've done my mechanical engineering from IIT Roorkee. And after that, I interned with Avishkar Intelligraph Group in Hyderabad.
My name is Akash Sharma. I'm from Mumbai. I did my mechanical engineering from Pradhan English College in Mumbai, in Navi Mumbai. My native is Sada.
You are first year students or
second year?
Where did you do internship? Have you done any internship?
Yes, I did my internship. Yes.
No, no, carry on.
I did my internship at Petrofac in Mumbai itself.
Petrofac?
Yes.
I am Jairam. I am a textile engineer from Usmania University College, fresher. I did my internship at Airtel and US.
Okay.
I did my schooling in Bangalore and then I went to NIT Surat Kalp for my mechanical. We two students, so I did my internship in ICICI Bank class.
Okay, and what about you?
Okay, my name is Latik. I did my mechanical engineering from SRM University, Delhi campus. And I did my internship in DCM Chira.
Okay.
I did my schooling in Ahmedabad and Mehsana.
Okay, so what did you do before MBA? Like, tell me about your experience before MBA. What made you take up MBA, and like, what was your life before MBA, and how has it changed afterwards? If you can, anyone can.
So
I personally felt like I wasn't fitting into my engineering life. Like, it was a drag for the entire 4 years, and. Wherein I wanted to do, so I had creative interests from back when I was in school, which I wanted to take forward. And I thought the only way out of engineering through, and wherein I can probably put in my creativity, channel my creativity into something productive. And there came in, say, my interest in sales and marketing, which is why I took up MBA.
Okay, so you had an interest in sales and marketing that brought you to MBA?
Yeah, and the sales and marketing interest also came from my creative interest.
Can you talk a little more about that, your creative interest?
So, I was very much interested in, during my college days and engineering days, a lot of fests used to happen. I was always into the creatives and design team, or I would cater to their public relations and stuff. So, that sort of brought in the sales and marketing.
Good. Anyone else?
For me, the interest or my decision to take on MBA came almost in the 3rd year of my engineering. Similar to this, not much into engineering and thought of doing my own startup. Also worked in a few startups as marketing experts, not expert, but as marketing person over there. So that is where I started getting interest overall in the business administration part of any company, and not the core or technical part of it. But the first 2 years were enough for me to.
So, like, how many years after engineering and how many startups did it take for you to say, okay, I am or MBA it is?
Actually, in the last 2 years of my college, I was associated with 3 startups.
Oh.
One of them was my own, and one of them was my friend's, and one was a third person. So, the one which I started, it shut down in less than a year or so. We have a team of 6. And the one which my friend owns, it's still working. So I worked there for quite a long period, one and a half year. The third one, it was a very short stint.
My story is something similar. So even though I joined textile engineering, I had very good props in computer science for the first year, wherein people take courses from all subjects, right? So apart from that, I met a guy over in computer science department. We hit it off like anything. I learned foundation and advanced computer science and engineering. We started to build a product, couldn't complete it due to some other reason. So we felt like the best way for us, the OU is a good name in Hyderabad and in state of Telangana where I come from, but when you compare it nationally, that isn't that big a name. So we thought we should get some names behind us and also gain the relevant experience. He went to an IIT and I came to an IIM to study further, so that he could handle the technical operations and I could look at the business side.
I just happened to lose interest in engineering in my third year, so I didn't feel like I would be doing something valuable, and then the salary also isn't that high engineering, so I decided to switch to management.
So all of you have lost interest in engineering from the third year, like,
yeah,
so far.
My case was like after 25 months of my job in Petropack, I felt that to fast track my career, an MBA is required. Because I was stuck in the same job, for 1 month I was doing the same job, so I felt that I need to fast track my career, and hence I felt I need to do that.
Okay, what about you?
So, I had a mentor, I had this subject of operation research, and that faculty, like, he convinced me that when you go to a firm as an engineer, you tend to make tactical decisions, but when you do MBA, I did my internship in operations domain. So when you do MBA, you move on to the strategic level. So in the third year itself, he convinced me that MBA is a better option for me after mechanical engineering.
So for me, it was like my sister's friends were she did engineering. So after that, they went to IIM Ahmedabad. So like I knew them personally. So like I was kind of inspired. One of them went into Airtel and another was in Raymond. So I was like, okay, this is like a very good lifestyle to go for. So I was interested in the same career, so after engineering.
Probably one other factor which drove my decision was, I remember during the third year of our undergrad, since I'm from textile engineering, we had the opportunity to go to visit one of the textile manufacturing unit. There we saw the scale of doing the business, how many people it affects the employment and all. So that drove me that rather than being a job seeker, I should try and become a job creator. So that was
amazing. Great thoughts. Anyone else? So IIM Indore happened by design, or you have dreamt of studying in IIM Indore?
IIM Indore was also only
question.
As an aspirant, you
don't really have like a choice. So you sort of try your best and just start with whatever you get.
Yeah, IIM Indore for me, IIM Indore was the best option because the best size is larger and the environment is very different, because you end up being a competitive professional, so that it prepares you for the corporate world.
One reason why IIM Indore gets a preference for me is like I had offers from similar campuses. So the reason I chose IIM Indore is in the second year we have currently an entrepreneurship domain. So that wherein you can take 15 credits of courses, you can focus on your startup, product or idea, and you will be graded on basis of that. So that is one reason which drove me to IIM Indore.
And also there
and
is a
specific only to IIM Indore. As far as I know, it's only in IIM Indore, the entrepreneurship.
So
it's like people specialize in finance, marketing, right? So there is a specialization for entrepreneurship.
Okay, so for me, I like traveling. So there is this Himalayan outbound program which we have, which is specific to IIM Indore only. So it is a credit based program where we get to go to Himalaya.
Wow, really nice.
Other than that, there is also a rural immersion program in which we go to the villages of Madhya Pradesh.
Rural area of Madhya Pradesh.
And we
that we had in our first year, but it's like around a week, and we go to the village, we survey people, try to get to know their life stories, and try to
make an impact in that situation.
Yeah, please.
Most of the things are common across most of the IIMs, but these few things are
every
different. That's why I choose
factors.
For me,
only 6 IIMs are preferred always. Out of them, Indore does have.
For me, Himalaya and outbound program was
traveler. So, talking of stories, so now I understood. You did engineering, you didn't like the third and fourth year of engineering. Some of you had a passion for creativity and you came to IIM Indore due to various reasons, shooting for IIMs and getting one of the old IIMs, right? Now, how was your first day at campus was like? Like, what did you expect? What did you see? What was different? How, describe your first day. Do you remember any memorable incident from your first day? Just,
first
you know.
It was very confusing because it's a very big campus and we didn't know where to go there. I remember I was walking with my parents and then went to the wrong hostel first.
Oh my.
And the car is also not accessible to every part of the campus, so I walked all the way down the net to come back up to find my correct hostel.
For me, I came into campus late at night, like around 12 or 1. The first thing which shocked me and surprised me was people were still roaming around doing group discussions, preparing, having fun. Basically, the campus was still alive at that late in the night, so that was pretty surprising.
Any of you else who want to share?
Like for me, it was like, okay, getting into IIM Indore, okay, it's a great thing. Like, and then you come, you start, like you travel from there, you see that dome thing from, like you can understand,
yeah.
Okay, that is IIM Indore. And like the person you're traveling with, if it's a driver, he also, he'll be, okay, that is IIM Indore. From there onwards, you're like, okay, I'm going into IIM Indore. Then that gates, everything, like.
So, what about you?
Same, like first day I come here, I've seen a lot of people, I come alone. And then other people were with the parents, so some of them I saw, and I didn't know that they would become friends during the long course. So now they
okay. Are. So are you happy or sad?
Happy.
What about you?
Same. I think in the initial days you're sort of confused about the kind of interactions you will have with people and whom should you choose, the kind of friend circle you want to have in the long run. But at the end of the day, like I today realize that everyone ends up being, despite of having such a huge bag size, we sort of still end up being friends or know everyone, and yeah, so that's more or less.
Yes, anyone else?
What happens, I mean, how do you, like, there must be about 350 students.
Okay,
right?
So regarding that, the institution actually has a plan for that. See, the MBA course is for 2 years, right? We don't get a time to bond with people. Like, so what the institution organizes is, there's this one-day program called Outbound Program,
okay,
wherein the entire PCB1 is divided into section wise, and a lot of activities are conducted so that at least the intra-section camaraderie builds up. So
this
that's
happens
a very
on the very first day.
That happens on the very first day.
It's not the first day.
So how do you spend your day one? Like what all things you do?
Day one is very active. Like we have a lot of
orientation from the director, sir.
Okay.
Along with the CEO.
We also teach us how to approach two cases on the
basically it was an induction week, not a day or so. First day was the orientation from the director, then second day, as you said, the instructions on the case, how to follow a case, how to read it, then outbound program, watching other activities.
Another thing I personally remember, like I spent a significant amount of my first day at HRC, where you have a lot of, for example, there are banks.
All the banks are waiting.
So for local, then there are,
first week is very
high. In fact, the first day is taking
registration, ID cards, biometric.
So they basically
your first SIM card and
give you debt even before you start earning.
And again, there are many events like section wars, and we talk to people, get to know
that
about
that
them.
Takes
how,
place
and
a
many
so
events,
sections
many
are there?
Okay, eight sections.
First year, there are eight sections. So how many students in each section?
Around
65 to 70 on average.
65.
So how
is
has
it become very competitive? Like you see 350 IIM Indore guys inside the room. What sense that it gives you? Like,
it's very competitive, but mostly healthy competition, I think.
Okay.
There are jokes about the competition, so I'm sure it's healthy.
Can you share one or two of them?
I mean, yeah, there's a running joke about relative grading. So since we have relative grading, meaning the person who gets the highest gets equivalent to full marks.
Correct.
So it is not like you have to score, say, 40 plus, you have to score more than most of the class. And which is why a lot of, say, if there is someone really studious who wouldn't share their notes because it's relative grading, otherwise they might have to help other people. We have a lot of running groups like that.
Nice. And so you are talking about the induction, the first week, right? Has the induction in some way defined what you want to do in the coming 2 years or in your career? The cases and all these things, has it in some way defined that, okay, I want to get into marketing or I want to, you may have had a perception before MBA and after getting in, has that changed or how has the first week actually?
Not necessarily first week, but over the course of the last 1 year, we have been able to redefine our priorities, and also the internship experiences helped to make that decision.
So, I mean, the induction part, I think it has more impact on smaller decisions that we take. For example, which network am I going to use throughout the 2 years depends on the...
And during that induction outbound program which we were talking, so in that we learn how to trust your teammates because there are different physical activities where there is free fall. So 6 people stack and one person has to fall from 8 feet. So you need to trust your teammates and various other things which like inculcates team building spirit.
Basically, it's about forcing people to interact with each other so that they get friendlier.
And about the
field, okay, it's like a yeah.
It's in a good way actually. Yeah. It's a very good way.
And about the our domain of interest, we get to like know during the first year only.
So you guys decide that I'm gonna take such a specialization in IIM
first year. First year we have domain courses for all the domains.
Like none of you have thought through that I'll do a marketing or a
some people have that, but some people change, some people don't change.
A lot
it's
of
very individual decision.
Yeah. A lot of times it does end up changing because only after we go to through these foundational courses in our first year, we realize how much we are into that subject.
Yes.
Okay.
So, for example, then take corporate finance versus marketing. So, a lot of people have the perception that marketing is not about numbers, but marketing does end up being about numbers, and corporate finance does end up being a bit subjective. So, those sort of decisions come underway over the time of the first year.
And so that relates me to another question. What was the first time that you started thinking about the career choice you want to make after coming into the B school, after getting into IIM Indore? I'm sure it's different for different people.
So, prior to coming here, I already made the choice to do in operations, so that has not changed since now. So mine is the same. From first day, I wanted to have a career in operations, so that is still the same.
And that is because?
Because I had past experience and related to operations.
Okay.
Initially, I wanted to again get into the startup with my friend who is studying in IIT right after my postgrad. But my internship and the time spent over here interacting with people, especially our work ex and all, that made me realize that I need to get an insight into how industry actually performs and functions before, you know, starting out with something on my own. That is one decision probably.
So, as I said, I already decided operation, but in second year, we have a unique way of selecting our electives. So, we do not select entire operations things, but we get to choose from different domains. So, like what I chose was 2-3 subjects of strategy, plus marketing, plus operations, plus finance. So, in that way, I diversified my subjects so in order to have better knowledge.
Yes,
and I'm doing I did not have a preference, but right now I'm leaning more towards finance because mainly because of the faculty that taught me, I've gained a bit of interest in that domain.
Actually,
okay. It's the same for me also. Like I actually was interested in marketing, and when we came in, like our marketing professor is like the way he explains the cases or something, the way we go through case with them, it's actually very interesting. So like you can actually feel okay that you are solving a major issue. So that kind of feeling comes, and then you are like, okay, through.
Okay.
It's slightly interesting. So how much this professor influence you have?
Yeah.
Like two of you are mentioning that has driven you towards selecting your specialization. So how much of an influence do you have, say, a professor, alumni, or your seniors? How much force do they put in into you to select a specialization?
Definitely, faculty influences a lot depending on which faculty. So since we have 8 sections, we have different faculties teaching as well. And a lot of times, a certain faculty may have a lot of influence as compared to the other faculty. So if, say, a section gets that faculty, it's likely that a lot of students, especially those who were indecisive about where they wanted to go, end up taking or maybe get influenced towards that kind of subject. So that is very likely.
No, this is slightly surprising here because all along, whenever we run so many events, you know, whenever we say that, can we have one of your faculty as a jury to evaluate you? You know, unanimously there is a no from student community. I'm getting a slightly different picture from you also. That's why I'm slightly trying to probe further into it. Does it like actually help you to select options or weed out options? Is a good faculty
was
a matter of
helping in the elimination option.
Yeah.
Initially, general and operations and marketing were my 3 preferences.
Mm-hmm.
So, operations is not one now.
Okay.
So, example.
So basically, faculty defines.
I think it's basically how we go through the. Like, we have this case method, like, I think most of the IIMs do have that. So how we go through that is what I think influences.
So because like, there is a preconceived notion, like, I studied operations research in my college, but here it is operations management. Right. These subjects are very different. I came up with something else in mind, and here I learned something else. So because of which I thought that this is not for me.
Yes, because most of the people who join MBA college, they have a very different picture. Suppose we all see movies and we derive our inspiration from this. So, like many of the people I know, they came here thinking for investment banking, and these people are freshers. So, but later on, they come to know and these factors, and faculties tell us that this is the actual work which an investment banker does. So it is very demanding thing. So people refrain from it later.
Even factors like work-life balance or ambition, what they want to do 5 to 10 years down the line, such factors also do affect.
So now we've got a perspective that faculties have a major influence on what you do as a career. What is your first choice? What is your first interaction point? Like how many of you actually interact with your seniors, or who else do you interact with to gain an insight and define your career apart from the faculty?
Okay, so the thing is, I am, after getting selected for IIM long back, our seniors back then organized something called Rendezvous, which an alumni freshers current batch meets.
Sorry, what was it?
Rendezvous.
Rendezvous.
So there is this Rendezvous, okay.
Yeah, there is this event. Rendezvous. In which alums and the people who will be joining IIM Indore, they interact.
Current senior batch. They organize a get together in, like, let's say 6 to 8 cities across India.
That is our first point of contact
before entering the campus.
Yeah,
correct.
And
okay.
Then we are also assigned a mentor. Each one of us is assigned a mentor before joining here. So you, in case of any doubts or something like that, we can always contact me.
And before the session starts, we
are your envisaged senior.
Yes,
the mentor.
Before commission. And before the session starts, we are also assigned the faculty mentors to solve whatever.
If we have any issues.
There are faculty mentors.
Yes. Faculty mentors plus student senior mentors.
And otherwise also any senior you can approach it as well. It has never been an issue for any one of us during the first year.
So is there a senior junior cordial relationship, or there has been a little struggle before?
A lot, in fact, a lot of us, since you were asking about which domain we prefer, where we want to go, a lot of us derive inspiration from our three seniors. So if you look up to a senior and a certain senior has interned at a place, we like to intern at the same place and we start seeing ourselves in their shoes.
So for people who have work experience, you may find the seniors are sometimes junior students, like in the previous college or something.
Yeah.
So some of our seniors we already know before, prior to coming over here. So they are like friends to us.
So do they make you do their assignment?
No, that has nothing. So because in my engineering college, we used to call it sir to our seniors. So when I came here as a fresher, so I said sir to a few people and they were like, don't call me sir. Now I am telling it to my juniors that don't call us sir.
Nice, breaking the barriers
yeah,
of
yeah.
Actual senior, junior. So as you have gone towards your MBA, after your induction, after talking to all the stakeholders, you know, you are making your decision. Has adding of information at each level influenced your decision for a particular field more and more, or has it confused you more and more?
It has influenced. I think it made our choices more clear. I don't think any of us would be confused to have more information. It has always been that if you're told something, it adds to a decision.
Be it guest talks or preconceptions, anyway, it has only added to what we already wanted.
Definitely it happens that now I'm feeling I should go for this domain, after some days I'll feel this, then again I'll feel this. That also does happen at times.
So when do you start planning for your internship? Which, like now
for
you...
For the internship,
yeah.
I think it's from day one itself. Because in the initial days here, we have talks by different student committees and they make us know the importance of the internship, since that is going to lead us to the eventual career. And the first term itself is very taxing because we have to first that's our first time in the campus, and on top of that, that's when the internship and all the talks and everything starts.
So we have this prep com session. So in this, like I went to it to tell the students my experience for internship to our juniors. So we share our experience to juniors so that they come to know how it feels to be in operations or consulting and what are the...
How do you guys make choices that these are my 10 brands that I'm going to hit for and these are definite 10 brands that I'm not going to touch? When does and how does that happen?
So, like the initial, like when you, before joining, you have this idea that okay, I'm going for these brands. That is basically from the report you read about, a placement report or something you read about the college.
Correct.
But after coming here and like we have these PPT sessions conducted by PlaceCom. So, when you go through that, you actually get an idea, okay, this is what they are offering. So this is not exactly what I wanted. So based on that, you do change your decisions.
And so apart from brands as a factor, I think role plays the most.
Yes.
So that is more important. What kind of work you are going to.
So are you saying that brand won't matter to you and only
no,
the role?
Brand matters, but the role brand first roles. Role gets the priority
over the brand.
Then brands. Brands which offer those roles.
And there is this one factor. In my first year, I used to like not know every company which comes to Ivindor, because most of the B2B companies are not that much known. So I almost knew most of the B2C companies like Raymond and Aditya Birla Group, and all these companies I already knew. But companies like DCM, Shriram, where I interned, I didn't know about it beforehand.
So, probing a little bit deeper into that, into this aspect which I was talking about, you know, what influences your decision, like you must be doing your own research and you must be interacting with others to understand. If I were to give a weightage, how much would your own research and your own conviction matter as compared to what you discuss with your faculty or seniors?
Not so much with the faculty actually, as far as the decision of joining which company I'm joining, mostly the student community and therein I think it, for me at least, it would be a 70-30 break, where 70% of the information is all from outside and 30% only is my conviction, because over time, in the first term itself, I realized that I did not know much, I did not know enough to decide where I wanted to go, and that was the, my information source was were people and the student community
as well.
So before coming here, only the like our some of our research mattered, like we see ads and we when we hear the same names in the placement report like Raymond or say Aditya. So we feel that we should be going to that company. So we aim for that before coming over here, and then the student community.
And suppose movies, so we had this movie, The Internship.
Google-based
movie. Okay. So that also creates and like influences us, because most of the people wanted to go to Google, because after seeing that movie.
Google boss doesn't pay much. Have you seen, check their stipends?
For the folks that they give
the thing is like you see their like the way they treat in like movies and you are like okay fine that is how we'll get treated.
Movies also create a perception.
Yeah.
That's what I mean.
So although a lot of other corporates might be giving similar perks and stipend, for example, but since we have this Google brand
awareness, okay.
Basically, like we are not like we don't get to see about them more often, right? Like most of the Indian brands, like. They don't portray as a very, like, we don't get to see them as a friendly brand in, like...
Employers' point.
Yeah, like, so we actually miss out on that part.
See, tech companies build a very good image of themselves in the public, right? So that is probably what we can
change. Okay. One of you talked about the entrepreneurship scheme of things,
yeah.
I think. You. So, how many of you are here to get a good job and career growth? And how many of you want to actually take your learning into starting your own thing?
As I said, that was actually my first decision to start up my own thing after graduation. But talking to people, seniors, people with tech projects and all, I reconsidered that. Right now, I am looking at, let's say, 3 to 5 years of work experience, then starting entrepreneurship.
Even I'm looking for that option. I want to start up not right now, but 8 to 10 years down the line, when I'm a subject matter expert, when I know the industry, when I have the network already in place. Because
I failed once or twice before. I don't want to happen that. I don't want to lose confidence again.
So I want to become a subject matter expert first, and then.
So for now, I guess everyone wants to have a good job, because there is a huge loan assignment.
Yes.
So that.
But if you are a owner of a business, you can just pay it off in one shot.
There is no concrete idea.
Comes with a huge risk.
Okay, so the next 3 to 5 years are set for all of you, that you're going to work somewhere pay off your loans, get a better idea of industry, and then probably start your own thing if you want to. Okay. Talking of that, so basically now we have covered how and what you want to do after, you know, the first few months of MBA. Now, each of you must be discussing amongst yourself about companies. You must be having, this company is like this, that company pays higher, you know. So, how does an impression about a company form in your mind? Like, can you elucidate? You can just, you know, freewheel about these things.
So, I think stipend sort of, although stipend may not matter, but it sort of, we have this mental ranking of companies.
Yes.
So if a company is paying a higher stipend, it automatically sort of becomes better than the other brands, for example.
So, I mean, according to you, can you name your first five?
For me, since I am very much inclined towards sales and marketing, for me it has mostly been HUL, ITC, L'Oreal, Colgate, and then something like ABFRL, Raymond, if I want to go into the fashion brand. And yeah, that's so. At this point of time, I'm not sure how would I have decided back in the point. And in fact, at the end of the day, while I was so inclined towards sales and marketing, I couldn't get into an internship in any of these brands. And I had to take up a marketing role in a tier 2 consulting company. But eventually, it does matter. I think people form their mental images of the brand according to the stipend for once. And apart from that, what we were talking about earlier, that they have their mental images, preconceived notions from before when they come to campus.
Like brands, so, brands in use also matters. If
yeah.
you hear that it is doing something good or it is going in an innovative way or something of that sort. That
one more thing is like how you interact with your seniors and they tell their experience. So if let's say their experience has been very good in that particular company, then you actually rank it a little bit higher than the companies.
Okay, so I will just tweak my question a little bit. Like you said, before interning, you wanted to know which is the higher paying stipend, and you wanted to go there. That it becomes an image that this company pays the highest stipend, I would want to go there. After interning, so can you also answer in two parts? After interning, with your experience in that company, and before interning, what was your image?
So it wasn't ever like we wanted a very high stipend. So if you're getting anything above, say, in an internship, if any company pays above 70, it's usually fine. And our average although is 1.24. So, but still, what we believe is that if a company is paying higher, it's likely to be a better company for an employee.
Yeah, but that doesn't really apply to all of this.
Yeah, I mean,
not everybody.
Yeah, not choosing. Yeah, so because I had like mostly, as I said, that people. I wanted to do internship in a company which people already know, so that I can tell that I did in some other Raymond's that people already know. But I applied for it at Indian shortlist, so I did in DCM. But I have to explain people what DCM Shriram actually is, what business it is. So.
So before the internship, obviously first year we all think of a stipend and all. After the internship, it is usually about the role and the profile, about the work we have to do. And if that is interesting, we obviously work in the same company because there is always a pre-placement offer or something like that. We always want to work in the same company.
There should be a match between our values and the organization's values.
That also matters.
Yes.
What all, I mean, now you said stipend, then the role, then the values that you're talking about. And after that, what are those, if you have to put out a couple of more attributes, what will be those attributes?
Not many people, but very few people actually even look up the location as well. Very few. Actually, that's all.
That's an interesting
thing. Last in the
yeah, somewhere in the end location.
Okay. So, what about, I mean, none of you have kind of mentioned about the culture of the company.
That does play a role, and also, like, if you know some, like, you do look up in LinkedIn what they are doing, or people who are already working there. So even they actually form like an impression on us. Okay, let's say a good profile is there in LinkedIn who are already working in that particular company.
Mm-hmm.
So like, okay, this is the kind of lifestyle that we may get, or this is the career path that we may also get to take up.
Okay.
So then, okay, that also influences the people around.
Also, during our internship, we interact with the employees as well. So we get to know that what is the career path there. Because they tell us how fast the promotions are there and how are the increments. So during that internship, we get to explore about the company a lot. So it also matters the career path that company provides.
And every year we also are told about the experience of the last batch, how, what role they played in that organization and how their experience was. So since for summers we don't have much information about what we'll be doing and what our choices are, so our seniors' experience plays the most important role.
How about the project itself?
Yeah.
Does that also attract you to
come side apart?
See, the problem with that is projects aren't decided in beforehand by many companies. I don't think any company, while pitching for the summer internship process, discusses we will be working on this project or anything.
Okay.
So that we get to know anyway after we join that company, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I don't think that is a big problem. But the seniors who have done their projects, yes, if we expect
but
some similar kind of thing, that is also criteria.
But we do tell our juniors that this company gave a really good project.
Yeah.
It involved a lot of strategic level thinking, and we do tell our juniors so that they can decide better.
So which companies are considered the best when it comes to giving out projects in your numbers? Couple of brand names that you have a top of mind.
Project wise, S&M companies, most of the S&M that are offered a lot of, so their projects are usually not as much looked up to because they end up offering a lot of sales or
field
work. So from student point of view, since we are management students, we always wanted to do something strategy oriented.
Consulting roles are always
market research.
More on marketing and less on sales is good.
Students expect.
So if you have to kind of rank preferences of these sectors, I'm not talking about the companies here. The sectors like investment banking is first sector, then
consulting.
What would be the order of it?
That would vary
depending on the person,
yeah.
Interest of the person.
But if you consider the majority of the batch, where do they look up?
Again, you can say, for example, last year, for our seniors, 27% went into finance. Okay. The year before that, marketing. I think marketing was the highest. So
mm-hmm.
It varies from batch to batch, person to person.
But people do look up to IB roles and consulting roles. That's
that
for sure. IB is like most odd because they pay high-paying jobs.
Right. So IB, then consulting, and then third, fourth, what would be the place?
Operations,
sales and
marketing.
Although the majority always goes to marketing.
That is
because
always
the
primary
agency
comes. Okay. Then.
So S&M is very short, but that is in terms of the quantity. So a lot of our students would want to go it, but I'm not sure. Like we've never seen a lot of our toppers, class toppers, going.
Okay.
They usually prefer IB or consulting.
So which are the top of the mind companies that come here? If you can name a few names, you know, the top companies
like
that come here.
Everybody's dream company,
yeah.
Everybody wants. I know that will be personal, as you mentioned.
So
but if you look at, have to, you know, kind of categorize couple of companies which are like, yes, this is the company that every student of IIM Indore would like to join. Which would be those brands?
But I think that varies according to the system also, sector. So in IB you'll have JBMC, Goldman Sachs,
Deutsche,
and in consulting BCG, and on top premier.
Yeah.
For operations you also say Amazon, say
Uber. Amazon, Uber plays, I mean they are still the guys to look out for.
Yeah, in operations.
And S&M actually has a lot of
SLM also has divisions.
So in
FMCG, some people want FMCG, some want clothing.
Yeah, retail sector, yeah.
Okay.
Retail sector,
retail
there is Aditya Birla Group, Raymond's, and
for
Raymond's
FMCG,
and Aditya Birla Group, sort of.
Yeah, at least in retail. I mean, in the fashion
retail.
And for FMCG, actual ITC, L'Oreal, Colgate, Dabur.
Even some students want to get into leadership roles, like general related roles, if Aditya Birla Group, Reliance, such companies, even Cipla, they give out leadership, since looking for leadership roles.
Okay.
And there are specific programs, 1 year training program just for creating leaders for the company.
Mm-hmm.
So that is also sort of
it. So in Genman per se, which will be the top 5 brands that you would consider?
Aditya Birla Group,
Reliance,
Airtel.
Relaxation
Mahindra,
General.
Jindal's.
Jindal's.
Okay.
What about in marketing?
Marketing is mostly the top FMCG brands.
So you mentioned about leadership roles, right? So like a company gives a very high salary, but it does not give a leadership role of your expectation. But another company is giving a lower salary, but the role is more meaty. So how does this role versus money salary play up to you all?
Yeah, it depends, because for me, I will go for role, because most of the companies give posting in Mumbai and Bangalore specifically. So I have a home in Mumbai, so I will definitely go for a role, because money is not that an issue for me. But people who come from outside, living in Mumbai is quite expensive, so maybe they will go for money.
But that too is like a minimum expectation.
Yeah.
Once that benchmark is
surpassed,
they definitely expect leadership roles.
Yeah,
they
just starting your career, right? So role plays a
role. Because you need to speak about something. Like as we did internship, in interviews we know that we have content to speak. So if you get a good role, at least you will get to, you will be able to explain people that you did this important role, and it matters a lot.
Moreover, we also have an understanding that if the company is investing in us and getting us on board for an internship in a leadership role, they are interested in us for a longer term. So that is also one major factor.
So
which companies kind of, I mean, without naming the companies, when you go for an internship, what are certain things which touch your heart, and what are certain things which like, yeah, ये काम है फर्स्ट किया.
First one which I feel would be the warmth or buddy mentor system. I guess that would be number one, because many, not many, but freshers especially would be new to the corporate world.
Mm-hmm.
Apart from that, any organization is like a different living being in itself. Values, culture, everything is different in that. So probably somebody to guide you across, help you across the first few days, and probably, you know, even for your further career, that would be one primary reason.
One major, other major factor is the boss, the person who we are reporting to.
Mm-hmm.
If he turns out to be cooperative and helpful, then we surely, that has been my case. My manager was very supportive and very cooperative. So that has helped me a lot during my internship.
For how many of you kind of boss defined the experience in the internship?
For me,
I was reported to many people, so it wasn't just one. Although I did have a fixed mentor, but I worked with a lot of people, so for me it didn't matter that much, because I had other people I could talk to.
A few of my friends told me, like, they went into good companies, so they expected kind of good work, but being very busy people and all, they were just given to do this stuff, do that stuff. They didn't really get to get a great experience.
Like basically you feel that, okay, this is something that I'll be doing in that particular company, but you end up there and let's say you are not given that what you are expected, let's say you are asked to do something else. In that time, I think when you are not, like, they are not able to live up to your expectations, that is when I think we face the problem. Other than that, I think the good parts are already.
So a lot of students complained about, like, they were just given the work and asked,
they were
too
busy to mentor.
Yeah. And in my case, at least my mentor told, so when I asked him for the work on the first day, he said, for 3 days you'll just learn about the company, and we'll sort of try to phase that into your project instead of just giving you the project. And the first 3 days it was more like a board session, a boardroom session, where he just told me about the company and how it is, how my project is associated with that. So that really helped me.
We feel that this mentor system plays an important role, because that would be the feedback which the senior students would be giving it forward to the junior students, right? So I guess that would also play a part in the decision making process. By if there are good mentors in the company, you get to learn stuff. See, money is different, but this also matters.
So actually, now all of you actually named out companies, why they are aspirational, right? Like, all these must be day zero and day one companies. So can you go company by company that is top of your mind, say, and why they are aspirational to you? Like, any company, why is it aspirational to you?
So one of the company that I aspire is Pratap Snacks. So
which one?
Pratap Snacks.
Okay.
So this comes later in the, during the
placements, say, after not on DMC Growth Given, but the role that it offers is very, very meaty, like it offers a role of strategy and operations, which I dream of. And like I said, the brand value may not be so much, but then the role is much greater than that.
Okay, so it's
and
a brand versus
about,
seniors.
Through seniors.
Yeah, they gave a very positive.
So apart, I mean, now this is slightly interesting that you're talking about. Is Prakash Nacks?
Yes.
Yellow diamond chips. So if you have to weigh that company against the stalwart, you will always weigh it higher.
Yeah, yeah.
And who will
this may not have been the case during the first year, but now since I have had some experience in internship with the MBA as a management trainee, I would definitely go for it.
So you will weigh it above Amazon and Uber and other companies that you mentioned?
I have not got a chance to work in Amazon because I was not shortlisted. Mm-hmm. But then it has always been a dream. So maybe this role has always excited me. Maybe I'll prefer this for some time over.
Alright.
Then get some experience and then maybe try for Amazon or something.
Okay,
so is it trade-off between role and
brand has been
higher for you?
Yeah, maybe Amazon offers the same role, but for now I just know about Prakash.
Okay.
What about others?
So
I think internships are dreamy while the final placements are sort of more practical. So during the internship time, there are also big brands and stuff. And the final placements, we are thinking whether or not it's a big brand, it should be where I want to live for the next 5 years or so. That kind of thing. So
after the by the time you reach your final year, you're even looking for a locational basis. Okay, let's say if I'm getting this location, that is more preferable to me. And then you go for the role, you change towards the role, looking for roles rather than stipend or salary. That also comes
about. Some internship is a short term commitment and final placement is a long term commitment. So we weigh very critically. Any student does that before.
So
intern be your dream company then. Perhaps he mentioned about
Pratap
Snacks.
For me it's HUL.
It's HUL always. For me. So did you get a chance to interact with those people? How did you form that perception about HUL?
So I have interacted with, say, the person was here for a talk and I got a chance to interact with them after the talk was over. And but mostly the perception has been because I tried a lot for it in during my summer internship season as well. And I've read about their sub products and brands and everything. So mostly the kind of overall image that HR formed is. And I've heard a lot about how they the employees are really happy. So when I was talking to this person after the talk, he also explained to me how their life is really chill and they get to he works from 11 to 5. He gets to go play in the morning. His life is basically enjoyable, and he has a lot of freedom, and the company takes care of him. And
so
that is for
HUL is number one for you in the SNM. Which other brands would be like, if not HUL, if you have a bad day with HUL, which other company would you go for?
So a lot of us, I think, have similar choices. So there are. Just the brands we mentioned, so there are top FMCG firms, the retail firms, like we mentioned. So, I don't know, ABFRL is Raymond, in the FMCG there's always ITC, and L'Oreal would be one of them.
So can I conclude by saying that if not HUL, anything below that, I mean anything after that would be a good choice for you, if not HUL?
See, HUL is like very competitive on campus, as he said, almost. Every guy who is into sales and marketing would dream and aspire to get into HUL, right?
Mm-hmm.
So the intake they take is very limited. So it's not like it's HUL or others. We keep HUL as a target, but we also prepare for the eventuality that we may or may not get into HUL.
So we have a lot, like we all decide many companies, not just one company, because as you know, the best strength is very high, so competition is high. So we.
It's like a pool of 12 to 20 companies. And
basically, like we just answered like the question, like what is your dream company? So okay, that is a dream company, but that is not basically that we are like okay, we have to get into
that. No, I understand that. So it's trying to assess the preference level.
Have you mentioned about your...
Yeah, so for me, I interned in Airtel and I found like the work culture to be very good. So I'm like, if okay, in final placements again, Airtel, if I get a chance to like convert Airtel, then I would...
Did you have a
PPO
from them? Did you have a PPO or PPI from them?
No, I did not.
Just to probe a little further, while you are saying work culture, you found it very good. What all constitutes the work culture in your mind?
Yeah, which so basically for me, one thing was the, like, for me, the internship period, the people who I worked with, they were actually very good to me. As in, like, if I had an issue, I could actually approach them, like...
Approachable.
Yeah, if
okay.
They were approachable to me. Mm-hmm. Like, for me, I found them approachable. Then also... their Gurga office where I worked, it was also like, you don't feel like, okay, I'm going into office to spend a whole day there and like feel tired. That feeling was not there. It was basically like, okay, it's an enjoyable place. Okay, you have a free time, you have like places to like hang out. So that kind of atmosphere was there. So that's what I meant by very good.
What would be your dream?
I would be to get into Aditya Birla Group. I have basically major conglomerates.
Hmm.
Aditya Birla Group, then Tata Administrative Services, and then Reliance Industries, Godrej.
Yeah.
These are my top 4-5
companies.
Yes.
For me, I would consider Reliance as my big company.
RIL.
RIL, yeah. That because according to my understanding and my research on Reliance, I feel there would be a lot of growth potential for Reliance in the upcoming future, and any company which grows faster and takes its employees also faster.
My dream company would be Goldman and followed by Deutsche Bank and JPMC.
IBs.
HUL, the operation scope and operation role is a lot.
Okay. So basically now let us come to, now we've understood your point of views on companies and what you look for, the work culture, the money, the role versus the brand. Now I want to ask you one thing. When you hear the word Raymond, what is the first thing that comes to your mind, all of you?
Complete
But to be frank, I use Raymond's a lot, so I like the company, the quality is good, and the price range is also good.
I think a lot of people on campus have
In fact,
people.
I think
we have an outlet.
We have the, what is that?
Discount from specific store of Raymond.
Basically, we have a tie-up, not we as in the institution, but there is a student body, Merchandise, which has a tie-up with Raymond. Wherein the incoming freshman first year students get a deal in terms of suiting from Raymond. So that's good. They get to experience. Many people have commented that it's good for the pricing they're offering.
Discussing about the brand Raymond for the students as company.
I think the problem is like people actually like when you are coming up in your like for me also like first year you don't know much about Raymond. You are like Raymond is like a only you know Raymond only through the ads. You don't know Raymond as a company.
Hmm.
But then like actually Raymond is a very huge company. Like you actually don't know about Raymond much in the starting. But I think if people do come to know like how
once the super starts, Raymond is a huge name over.
Any of you have interned with Raymond in amongst you? No. Okay.
So, one second. You said Raymond is a huge thing for internships.
Yes. Yes.
Summer
internships. Yes.
Why is that? I mean,
because of first because of the brand name.
Okay.
Second because of the rule it offers.
Okay.
And third because everyone is associated with Raymond in some other way.
Yes.
Like even at my home, if I tell them I want a suit, you have to have it.
Raymond.
And if you say at home we are interning at Raymond, then it is a very big
Are they looked at like heroes of the badge? If you
No, not exactly. But that's not that side.
Because it is sought after.
Because as he said that fashion retail, maybe Aditya Birla, Raymond, these are the brands which are like famous in.
I think the part he mentioned about recognition, that actually comes from the brands people know about. Like, let's say DCM,
it may not happen to the students inside because they are still aware of all the other brands and stuff. But when we go back home, for example, we just need to tell them the name and they recognize.
Okay.
Yeah.
So friends, relatives, parents. Okay.
No other company, I guess, has.
Yeah, everyone.
Even like
complete
companies point. Like you, if you tell, okay, I worked in. Let's say
even HUL, if you say
HUL, people don't know HUL as a.
People know their products. People know Pepsi. People don't know HUL.
Even Amazon, if you say, they will think it is some sort of app. And
now, okay, it's different. Like now, you say Flipkart, Amazon, they're like, okay, you worked in Flipkart. That thing is there. And Raymond, I think, has the same image. Like when you say Raymond, they are all like, okay, we know Raymond.
It's someone in a smart suit.
Yeah.
And,
yeah.
So that brings me to an interesting exercise that we can do now. So basically, you select a Bollywood star and relate that star to one of the companies. Probably we'll start with Raymond's and then you can say which star is what company and for what reason. Yeah.
Okay.
What would Raymond's bring to your mind?
It should be an anonymous answer.
Yeah.
Yeah, it should be better. So,
yeah.
The thing is, like, when you think about suit, like, two things like that pop up. One is Louis Philippe and then next, like, Raymond. So I think whenever you see a star wearing a suit or something, you actually associate that, okay.
So if you have to associate
still
one particular
one
Bollywood
star.
Okay,
who
does it? I don't know, maybe Ranveer Singh, I think.
And why?
Like,
he's
most...
favorite.
Huh? No, not exactly, but the thing is, like, the problem is I'm not much associated with Bollywood as such. Like,
so, what, Hollywood or...
No, I'm... Since I'm a Kerala, like...
So, Hollywood, right?
No, like Malayalam, I don't think we have a Mollywood.
Is it?
Yeah.
So which star, like?
Okay, then obviously Dulquer Salman comes into play.
Dulquer.
Yeah.
Okay.
So
what star would you guys?
And
no, actually they are like of a generation, past generation. Now the coming up stars they have this trending. Like suits as such has in Malayalam industry has been recently launched. Like recent, it's a recent thing that stars start wearing suits to occasions. Before that, it's the waisty and those things,
yeah.
Right? So even then, I think brands are there. But when you see a suit and you associate it, so that is kind of.
For me, Saif Ali Khan comes to my mind because he's associated with royal teams because being an Nawab. So if he wears a suit or something like that, it would be so.
Yeah, I think Saif Ali Khan or maybe Shah Rukh Khan
will
success and... So how many
of you Shah Rukh Khan, like, or which other?
Saif Ali Khan.
Saif Ali Khan.
Because
for
all of you, is it?
For yeah,
the
when we think of Raymond,
it's
quality and when if you
try to suit up a person with a great personality, with a very good body,
good
shape, that
it's
a perfect
fit. Yeah.
Like I'm surprised when it comes to suiting and when I spoke to other institutions, everybody said Amitabh Bachchan.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I think it's become too old for your generation.
When you think of suits and Raymond, but respectable classic, some classic image comes to it.
Yeah, so correlate with the brand. Like brand image, okay. Suppose, yeah, like that you can correlate.
Still taking Saif
Ali Khan
because
of the royalty.
Royalty factor.
Not just royalty.
He can carry it.
Why
we
would say Amitabh Bachchan because he's from another generation.
Okay.
Although Saif Ali Khan is also from another generation.
But did he tell him?
Yeah.
Agent
who
Vinod.
Who also married a woman of your generation?
No, like association is easy. Like you
so,
now also you see them.
Yeah,
in the
Indians raised to I guess he has like all the time. He was all the time wearing suit. So
yeah. Agent Vinod also.
Yeah.
So what other brands you associate with other stars? Like among the top of the mind. And why?
Why would Aditya Birla Group Retail come?
Okay, the like that's what I was about to say. Like when you said brands, like. Suddenly what came to my mind was Fruity and Shah Rukh Khan. But that is not a brand exactly.
No,
that is
a brand.
Brand.
When you say a recruiter,
yeah,
a recruiter in your campus and the Bollywood star, how will you associate them? Maybe HUL. Which star will you associate with HUL?
HUL as a brand?
That is
it's
the problem.
It's
divided into.
It's difficult because there are so many
products.
Yeah. That's
not
really
an
employer,
I'm
saying. The product size you can
yeah.
ignore, but perhaps that should have an impression in your mind,
yes.
The way they do the advertising and all that. But as a
okay,
company,
yeah.
if you have to associate that with this thing.
I would associate this more with the director, say Rajkumar Garani or something, because whatever he makes, it sells.
Yeah.
So, so
excellent.
Yeah.
All of you agree?
Yeah.
Okay. Any
where
other?
Would JP Morgan come?
Okay, brand.
Goldman Sachs or JP Morgan?
Does it have to be male
character? No, it
no, female.
Female character also.
No problem.
I mean, you have to define whether it is a male or female and then.
And why?
Associate Goldman Sachs with Priyanka Chopra because of the
international
affair. Yeah, the international factor and how it plays a sort of.
Yeah. Hollywood.
Yeah.
And Goldman Sachs is a US company.
Let's say Roshan also, I think.
Yeah, because in Zindagi, I'm like,
okay.
Yeah.
What about Tata, Mahindra? Why would that
Tata
be?
Tata probably went Amitabh Bachchan.
Yeah, actually,
yes, yeah,
an old man figure and a very successful figure. So, okay.
It's not old, but successful legacy as a
yeah.
legacy, big legacy and all. Tata and
then say Mahindra.
Mahindra.
Mahindra would probably
be Mahindra would be someone who like suddenly, you know, something.
More like Mahindra would be someone from the generation of Amitabh Bachchan, but not as
yeah.
Mahindra.
Mahindra would be Prabhas because he is in one of the ads of the
yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Then say Aditya Birla Group.
Hrithik Roshan.
Aditya Birla Group will be Hrithik Roshan.
Yeah.
Why? I mean, they are in the commodity business. And
yeah.
We are associating. Like, why would you say that?
Probably because. I don't know.
That's the impression you have in your mind. That's fine.
Yeah,
you
think mostly I'll associate Aditya Birla with some actress.
And
actress.
Like
Anushka yeah.
Sharma, because like, there's some homely factor and there is still. Just enough
trend,
of youth and just enough of homeliness and
achha,
so
there but not there actually.
Yeah.
It's like a trend also, like okay, like the fashion sense that they bring into.
Hmm.
So that also is kind of okay.
Anushka.
That's why I found female character.
Reliance?
Shah Rukh Khan. A lot of
Shah Rukh
Khan's
here.
Yeah.
Because of his closeness to Mr.
Yeah.
Because of his closeness to Mr.
Yeah.
Or because of the image that Reliance has and the way Shah Rukh Khan carries
yeah.
himself.
Because
does
for me, just mostly in newspapers we see both of them.
Both of them at event launch or even.
So you feel that like Shah Rukh Khan is the adopted son of. Okay.
I don't think Sharukhan needs
it. Reliance is almost close to the whole Bollywood, so
yeah.
Yeah.
There's no one as such we can point.
So Reliance will definitely be a male or a female?
Male.
Definitely be a male.
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 Why?
Which other brand? Say an Amazon.
Amazon.
Amazon is
Deepika Padukone. Why?
I know Amazon, you just associate efficiency, perfection and all this stuff.
So Deepika Padukone is the perfect one for you.
Maybe he has a large picture of Deepika Padukone in his hostel room. Then what else? Which other brand? What about this fashion brand like Tommy Hilfiger?
Ranveer Singh.
Like even Jack and John. So they basically have this connection,
correct.
Right? They are the brand ambassadors.
Mm-hmm.
Ambassadors. So that thing is there.
Okay.
All of these are casual, like they don't somehow look formal.
No, actually that
okay.
is where the difference. Like you
hmm.
said, people associate Raymond with Amitabh, and right now he said like we associate yeah, like Saif Ali Khan. So that is like they have that royalty feeling to it. And whereas like Ranveer Singh, you say okay, fine. Something like Jack.
Really important day, say in interview, we will prefer the classic look over the casual. So.
Yeah, because like people who are normal engineers, normal youth, they wear suits just for parties. But we wear
yeah.
for important things like meetings and.
Thank you in a corporate interview.
Yeah.
Right.
No.
Thank you for calling this as an important meeting.
Yeah.
So
yeah, basically
please
it's
sure.
I think it gives a person a character, like okay, you're like, okay, this person, you feel that person is very important.
Serious.
Like, just
yeah.
because of a suit.
If,
like,
even the candidate if he wears something like so he looks serious for the interview, like he is genuinely interested in the interview.
So now, you know, perhaps this was a good exercise, and we are coming to the end of the discussion, maybe another 5 more minutes and close it. So you have seen so many recruiters, you have gone through so many processes, you know, recruitment processes. What are those good practices that you feel that companies should definitely continue? What are those innovative practices that some other companies are bringing in that you feel that, you know, traditionally traditional practices should take a back seat and this new practice should take a front seat? And what are those definite no things that companies should not?
With respect to recruitment.
Recruitment, particularly the recruitment process.
Okay. So, one of the factors which I think is some companies do prefer past education, because most of us have like not that much good grades in undergraduation, because we did a lot of extracurricular activities. So they should give chance to those people also who have like not that good, who are not triple line, suppose.
Another thing, yeah, I feel is in the recruitment process, companies should probably do a with group discussions, because see, this is an IIM and everybody is hyper competitive, right? So when you give a topic to somebody and when everybody starts pitching in, I don't think it would be an effective way to screen out candidates. And that's a major factor, because let's say 10 people sit for a GD, only 2 people probably go on to the interview round as well.
Yeah.
So that would be a very difficult choice, and sometimes even a confused choice to make, which 2 we should send.
Okay. Group discussion.
Yeah.
No,
I don't know.
Why don't you agree?
First, in a group discussion, you if a person is standing out in a group discussion, usually then is when
he comes to know about his biases or something like that, his perception.
Mostly under pressure, and when so many people are talking, for generally sales and marketing roles, group discussion is a very good thing to identify a potential candidate.
Another way to put it would be that it should be really well judged. It shouldn't be
probably
say random, but group discussion I think is a major part, because anyway there will be so many applicants, so it will be tough to shortlist them without the GD.
You brought out an interesting point. So you talked about it being moderated well.
Yeah.
So you've had a experience where it's not been moderated well, and what could be an improvement that you feel in your mind?
So it is mostly, I mean, also this is something I'm not speaking from perspective, but I've heard a lot.
Yeah.
So often students say that someone who was speaking a lot was taken over someone who would have put in logical points. So therein we sort of hold the recruiter liable. That shouldn't be the case.
Okay. What about other practices? What other innovative practices are happening for recruitment?
From visibility point of view, maybe an improvement over GD would be this chairman GD. That takes a bit of time to come up, but that would even actually show you the leadership potential of the candidate as well.
So how many companies do chairman GD?
I don't think any.
I know TAS does it, but any other company does it?
That's
TAS,
not
the
many companies do that, but
probably
okay. They would.
Okay, what are the practices? Is there anything innovation?
Yeah,
innovative
actually,
that is
like even before the recruitment process, like just before, like even like when you are introducing a company to the campus, the way they portray themselves actually has effect. Like for example, like L'Oreal, how they come to the campus, that is a very like different feel. You are like, okay, L'Oreal is everywhere. They are conducting beauty,
experience. Okay. Apart from recruitment, they have various activities.
Okay. Yeah, they have a lot of activities.
Okay.
They try
else?
To engage with the students before the...
So do they draw out a shortlist or something by engaging the students?
No.
That
was
just like...
get visibility or
brand
visibility.
Yeah. So basically, we come to associate L'Oreal as a company who... Like,
who's big.
Yeah, who's big and... like cares for people or something like that.
So that's still a strong impression you had from last year for L'Oreal.
Yeah,
so good. So which other companies are like very strong in your impression considering the activities that they have in campuses?
So some of the competitions like Mahindra Workroom and also, they become very evident during that.
So the competitions which have become huge over time, obviously we get the association with the brand.
Okay. So which competitions are big here?
Suppose
he is
wearing a
T-shirt
of
Mahindra.
Okay. Then providing
merchandise. Yeah, providing merchandise. Freebies is always welcome. I know that. So what about other corporations? Like Mahindra Varuma and
Competitions, Stratos is huge, Lime by HUL, Stratos by
ITC,
Interobank by ITC,
Mahindra Finance. Yeah, a lot of competitions.
Okay, but these are like top of mind.
Yeah, and also one more differentiating factor is like a new competition comes up. Like recently, Google, I think this was the Google's first competition by Google. So that like you are not expecting Google to like you don't know if they'll have, like we don't know about the competition, but when they suddenly come up, I think that comes into the foreground. Like that becomes the focus for a.
So suddenly, if something is launched, that becomes a big thing.
Yeah, and if it's the like a
big
major
brand.
Thing.
Like, buzz.
Google has come, they are offering a competition.
And these mini brands also have this Facebook challenges or something like that. Like Regret Benziger had this type your name and this college name on the Facebook pages, and whoever, whichever college puts them.
But does this have any impact on you, like this minor thing of putting a name and this?
No, this was
a
piece of
it. It was more about accumulate together.
That it adds up the brand image.
They are focusing on the students, they want students to be involved. That is the message that they send.
So what sort of competitions are preferred in a campus, if I had to ask you?
Most of them are case competitions.
Case competition, do you guys will still participate in case competition or is there an overdose of that?
No, that's
a... No, so in first year there are many competitions which are common to both first year and second year.
Yeah.
So as a first year student, we did not have enough knowledge to compete with second year. So, as he said, Aditya Birla, they have this competition status which is only for first year. So, that way we can like...
And that is a very sought after competition and because I think they do roll out some...
Yeah, they do.
PPIs. Rolling PPIs or for summer internship? Because for
summer's
PPIs,
yes.
Okay. Okay.
That is always an incentive for the students. And
apart from that, apart from case studies,
so IB firms do have workshops and
yeah, they do have workshops. They don't have competitions. But what they do is they for different roles they come different times for different workshops.
So they gauge.
So they come to college like many times. Before the recruitment starts.
Okay. Is that appreciated, like one company continuously coming to the campus?
Yeah,
because I know HOL comes at least 5-6 times to your campus.
So
because the thing is, in first year people don't know much about, like people, most of us are engineers, so we don't know much about IB roles and what actually we have to do in sales and marketing. So by these workshops, they give us like it's kind of simulation kind of thing. We get to know that these are the things which we will have to do in such and such role.
Mm-hmm.
And this way we get to know the job role and the company as well.
Okay.
I feel campus should come to the company should come to the campus at least once or twice before the actual recruitment process, so that students get to know the company better.
I still feel that should be
considering Raymond as a corporation. What sort of an engagement would you prefer?
Raymond has one advantage when compared with other companies. Ki almost like 60-70% of the first year students buy their suits from Raymond in campus. So they already have that association.
Touch point.
Correct.
They just need to take it further by doing engagement drives in our campus. So that would probably increase the visibility of Raymond. And
so suppose you have to kind of chart out that.
So one thing which they can do is best suited person on the campus. They can start this competition.
Mr. I am Indore.
Yeah, that because best suited basically.
Not necessarily Mr.
Mr.
Complete man, woman.
Yeah, because
anyway they are running to
suits
too.
Yeah,
and they can even offer students like many of the companies not in our campus, but they do it that whoever wins, they will star them in their ads. So it will be a great incentive for people to participate.
Or maybe
but
even campus ambassador.
Campus ambassador and.
But is that good enough for you to consider any company as a
It depends on the people because some people who are into sales and marketing they go for these activities.
Actually,
we had this L'Oreal thing in which we had to make photos and upload on Facebook. So many people did it. And
In on-campus presence is more effective.
More effective.
Yeah.
But I do believe, like, if you club both his point and this point,
maybe
board,
both
like,
things can be done.
You know, the thing is, like, I think Raymond can present a case like a unique case because you see the complete man as a like a strategy that came up from Raymond. That's actually very unique. Like, you now when you say a complete man, you associate automatically.
Yeah.
Like, you go to Raymond. Correct. And that as a case study will be like, I think, a very good option too. So if you get a case like similar to that and you are coming up with such a strategy, I think it's
different. So should it be a competition or should it be a workshop?
Suppose if there is a case study competition and when the winners, campus winners are announced, then people from Raymond can come and they can do a short introduction about what roles are there, and during that time only they can do a half an hour workshop which will combine both of the things together, like prize distribution plus workshop.
How long this competition be? Like if I have to kind of define a time for
what timeline can be case study.
The window is around case competition. Window is around 10 days. Like
10 days. Okay.
Like, depends level 1, level 2.
I have a question. So basically, you were talking about L'Oreal having the selfie contest, and for Raymond's you were suggesting a case study competition. So I had a thought that, you know, the image of a company that you have in mind, you have a idea that, you know, they should do this accordingly. Like Raymond's is supposed to be a little premium Saif Ali Khan kind of a thing. So that's why you suggested a case study competition. If it was like a youthful L'Oreal kind of a thing, a more like a marketing
like
kind of a thing.
Like a
brand
also.
Yeah.
I suggested this suiting competition because it can also be good, because most of the people have suits and how
and
they wear
also
it.
Also, one more difference is the recognition that as in, if you say L'Oreal, you know the products, but you don't know the company as such.
Okay.
And Raymond is already Raymond also same thing. Like when you say Raymond, you know Raymond. That thing is there. Like
brand,
the name,
brand
association is pretty much high. L'Oreal as in has come up recently. Like if you see, L'Oreal was not that well known. In India it was not that well known, I think.
Okay. Do you have any case study chapters around Raymond's? No.
In
class?
No.
Okay. This entire thing brought me to one more question. That is like, first touch point mostly is a presentation, PPT, right? So, what kind of presentation do you people want to go for? Do you say ki this may be a bad presentation, you don't want to go? What defines a good presentation? What defines a bad presentation? And how is it adding value to your perception about a company?
See, the thing is, we can't really judge a company's presentation before going to a presentation.
Yeah.
Everyone would go down. That shouldn't be a problem.
Okay.
And depending on the activities in the presentation, that's up to the company. How do you want to engage the students?
How long this presentation should be?
Not more than one hour.
Including everything.
Right. 1 hour end to end.
Completely.
One thing which can be done is during presentation there can be some interactive activities, not only interactive like Q&A session, but some activities like simulation activities can be there. Which
on your phone and stuff like that.
And all.
Yeah.
Cool.
So we get some
distributing goodies after that.
That interest that pulls you to the presentation, and if you like it, probably the perception about the company evaluates.
You keep the students engaged.
Basically, if the person comes and just talks about the company and about the internship and then leaves, it would be very boring. So there will definitely need to be some engagement.
They wouldn't be connected with the students.
Yeah.
And also, does it help if an alumni of IIM Indore from that company also come along with
yeah.
Basically,
we also
get
a recent intern
is
possible. Like,
okay.
The thing is, good part will be like if an alum is coming, we actually get to know about his experience as well, right? So that is a
different. During the interactive session, you may give some tips.
Okay. So you are saying no to boring presentations, but to have interactive and value adding.
One of the companies had told us to install an app, and then they were playing a quiz and to vote for it. So this keeps the students active and engaged.
One more thing is, like as I had mentioned earlier, Raymond as a company is not like known to people. Like you know the brand, you don't know like how the company is. So like a PPT actually gives you the option to actually present like this is what happens in our company. That option is out
the
there.
Inside picture.
Yeah.
People know just about stores, Raymond stores, showrooms. They don't know inside picture. Like
where actually the
I am sure that Raymond is not only for like associated with suits. Like they have this recently they have this Khadi thing also like, starting up. So these things are like we associate mostly Raymond with suit. Those things are also like.
Have you guys attended Raymond's weekend? Any of them?
I mean, if you were to know one thing about Raymond's, what would that be? One factor that you may want to know but you've not known so far, or that you may want to know from the company, one important factor, what would that factor be?
So, what is the future direction they want to take the company? Textiles is okay.
So maybe something about, if I'm looking at it from an important lawyer's point of view, something about how people, because I cannot imagine how, what a Raymond office looks like or
office work
is like,
office
like
okay, pictures and work culture.
Yeah.
Also the
industry or completely obscure numbers, so that should be
okay. And your point was like future course of actions. How important is that for a person to want to get into the company?
As we know that many companies, they are expanding. So if a company is expanding, they have better opportunities. So that way, like suppose a company, as he said, as his preference is Reliance Industries. So as we know, they are investing in lot of companies, like lot of industries. So that way, if he gets into Reliance Industry, he has an opportunity to get into suppose telecom or their retail.
Clothing
sector,
everyone. And if the growth is
higher,
obviously our growth
will
also be
higher. Okay. So, what do you feel needs to be improved about Raymond's, like according to your perception about the brand? What can be improved? And what do you think is unique and what can be improved?
I think more interaction can be done.
On
campus,
outside
visibility is very, very high and very good. On campus visibility could be improved.
As a recruiter, Raymond's perception is different from a, as a consumer product. So that needs to be improved.
Visibility in campus is also high, but the interaction is not there. Like
that's what recruiter image.
Some engagement actually.
Have you guys applied for Raymond for interaction?
And what are, according to you, some of the key mistaken notions about Raymond's? You know, you think that this may be the notion, but this is not the thing. And how they can improve it? Any suggestions?
We know the notions, but we don't know
if they're wrong. Tell us the notions.
The same thing that it is very classic. It is meant for classic. It doesn't have a casual look. So that is
something could be, I think among girl students could be
the
some more female participants could have been
I mean
this is
man
more geared towards guys.
Yeah,
probably
okay.
Should target the second half of the
podcast. Perfect then guys, we are good with this. Thank you so much for your time. Hope you guys also enjoyed this discussion.
Thank you so
thank
much
you for your time. We really appreciate it. Different style of conduct.